I am so proud and happy to have here with me also in the studio, Andrew Sullivan, who is the CEO of the Internet Society. And you may ask, the internet, what is that all about? You are all using it, hopefully, to tweet to us and engage with us. And as we've seen throughout our show, sometimes some internet connections are stronger than others. And so what we'll want to talk about and discuss here is the digital divide and access to the internet and how oftentimes we leave people behind. So hi and welcome to our show.
Thank you for having me.
So you are at the Internet Society. Tell us what a day looks like in the work that you do at the Internet Society.
The Internet Society works to ensure that the internet is open and globally connected, trustworthy and secure. So the goal is always to make sure that people can access the internet. We work for an internet for everyone, and that is what we work on every day to make sure that people can access it, that people can use it reliably, and that they can trust that their connections are not going to be subverted in various ways.
Can you elaborate a bit more on what that means?
Well, there are a lot of concerns these days about the internet. You know, when the Internet Society was founded, nobody wondered whether the internet was a good idea. And nowadays, people are a little concerned. They feel that, you know, the internet causes them some difficulties, that, you know, there are leaks, there are attacks on you know, the infrastructure, but also attacks on various systems, and people start to wonder whether the internet was such a good idea. But the fact is that the internet is an enormous source of innovation. It's a tremendous potential contributor to the Sustainable Development Goals, for instance. And so what we see is, you know, we want to make sure, of course, there are real problems and we need to address those, but we also want to make sure that we have an internet that everybody can use and that can be, you know, a contributor to achieving those Sustainable Development Goals.
So it's fascinating because I think one of the things you talked about is the positive and simultaneously you also talked about the negative downsides of the internet. But as we're starting to think about access to the internet and increasingly thinking about access to the internet as I know I've seen it being called a human right, given the fact that there's so much data and so much information that someone who does not have access to the internet is missing out on, what do you feel about access to the internet? Is that in this day and age a fundamental right that we should be working for?
Well, I don't know that I want to, you know, decide whether it's a right. What I want to do is make sure that people have access to it. So for me, the question is less, is this a right, and more, what positive can come of this tool? So something like 50%, a little less than that, of the world is not connected right now. And in the least developed countries, this is much worse. Now, obviously, you know, if people are struggling for clean water or something like that, this is a less important thing. On the other hand, if you're going to develop, this is a fundamental tool. And the interesting thing about the internet is because it's distributed, there doesn't need to be an enormous investment. You can do different things in different ways in different locations, and you can get access. And that access is an enormous opportunity for people who get it. So what we see is that we want to distribute this this capability to everybody and to allow them to use it in order to achieve the goals that they need locally.
So I'm curious, as we're thinking about policy, we're here, as you know, kind of in the sidelines of the UN General Assembly. How does that interface with policy? How does access to the internet, in essence, how is it a policy issue or is it not?
Well, it is an issue. Without good policy, obviously, nothing will change. And you need innovative policies. So one problem that we've seen on the internet is that policies that were designed for a previous technological age are then applied to the internet, and it's inappropriate way of working with the internet. So that's one thing. You can harm things just by having the wrong policies. But the other thing about it is that you can positively influence the internet and positively influence growth and the development of the society by the right kind of policies, by choosing wisely in what you do and what you don't do. And I think that that's a key part. For instance, we see spectrum policy. Often spectrum policy is tightly controlled, and we find that if you change that a little bit, a community network can grow and can be built in an area, and suddenly people have access where they wouldn't have it before.
That's fascinating. I always joking and say to my friends that you always know a person's temperament when you take away their Wi-Fi. That's kind of where you start to assess someone's personality or whether they have Wi-Fi or not. As you're thinking about the future and the future of education and the future of the work that you all do, what steps are being taken to ensure that people increasingly have access? I mean, you said 50%. That's a very large number of people not connected. What steps are being taken and can be taken to ensure that people are connected?
Well, one of the things is that we work with policymakers around the world to try to show them policies that they could do that would change things. We also work directly. So, for instance, we work to develop community networks, and that's not just to build them and sort of drop them on people, but rather to build the local capacity so that people have this capability to do it themselves. Similarly, we work around security issues. So, for instance, we work on the fundamental security of the internet, and also on things like Internet of Things devices for consumers to make sure that people can trust these devices. So this is all effort that we are contributing to with a lot of partners. We work with many different partners around the world in order to make sure that this is effective for everyone.
Well, thank you so much. And if you're interested in following up with the work of Internet Society, definitely look them up. There's some fascinating research and data and studies there. So thank you very much for being with us here.